Hello. In this video, I will demonstrate the startup and configuration of a steute TCP IP wireless receiver. Here we have a demo version to show you. This is the device itself, the TCP IP receiver, which is connected to a notebook via Ethernet. The special thing about this TCP IP receiver is that the teach-in process does not use push buttons like other receivers. Here you can see a push button, but it is for performing reset or returning the device to its factory settings. We will not go into any more detail about that in this video. Here the entire configuration and teach-in process is web-based. That means that after we have performed some basic settings, we access the device via an internet browser, where we can perform various additional settings and teach-in our sample switch, in this case an RFR CM30. Wie gesagt, die Einstellung an dem Gerät vorzunehmen, müssen wir erst einmal die As I said, in order to set up the device, we first have to change the network settings of the device, in this case our notebook, by going to and opening the network settings release center. And then going to LAN connection. A window then opens and here we select features, allowing us to access Internet Protocol 4. This is marked and then by further selection we come to the settings for the network addresses. Und durch weiteres Auswählen der Eigenschaften kommen wir auf die Einstellung der Netzwerkadressen. Here we select use following IP address and enter for example the following parameters: 192.168.01.44 as the IP address and 3x255.0 as the subnet mask. The values of the IP address can deviate from computer to computer. Once we have chosen our settings, we confirm them with OK and then close all windows so that no more windows are open for making further settings, because we are now finished. This means that we are now able with the notebook and the network settings to communicate with the device. In order now to access the device, we have to start Mozilla Firefox, which is recommended for this application because of its stability. We now at the top select a network address in order to dial into our device. This one is 192.168.0123. All this information is also available in the mounting instruction for the device. We now select this address and, as you can see on the screen, the device remains selected until we come to this input mask. This means that now, in order to access the device, we must dial into the page of the TCP IP device using the username steute and the password steute123 and subsequently confirming the login. As we can see here, for the wireless sensor configuration, we have 40 storage slots. This means that we can assign 40 different switches to perform switching actions. But before we do that, we go once more into the device configuration. Here diverse values are stored, which can be adopted, such as IP address, standard gateway and port number. These are all stored in the device and can be retained. Once we have checked this, we go to the wireless sensor configuration and can now teach in one switch as an example via the RFR CM30, as illustrated here. In order to perform this procedure, we first have to set the device to learn mode. That means that we click up here on the learn button until we see a cross. We then activate the wireless switch, after which we go to the learn button again and deactivate the learn mode. Just now we were briefly in the teach-in mode to teach in our switch, which is now 1, as we can see here from this address, before we then left the learn mode again. The address is now known to the receiver, but we are still not able to communicate because we have to enter a setting in the address itself. To do this, we select storage slot 1, go to IP address and enter our network address 192.168.0144.
0 144 ein.
As the port, we select 44,000 in this case, whereby this is a random or freely selected number and can be anywhere between 10,000 and 99,000. Under protocol, we then go to the TCP client version, confirm under active with the cross and save the setting and return to where we were. We are now back at our mask, where 40 transmitters can be taught in and are now able to check the settings, check the teaching in. As we can see, at the end of this line there is a green LED, and if we activate it, that means the wireless switch is activated, on and off, then we can see that the LED flashes from green to orange and back to green. This means that the switch is known to the receiver and incoming telegrams will be recognized. This is the first step when teaching in switches to the receiver. There is also the possibility to visualize these incoming telegrams. For this, steute can provide users with a software which requires certain settings. I'm doing it now. I close the port and here the server to client is illustrated. The port must then be opened with these settings, which here are shown once again, as an example as 44,000 and IP addresses. Once the port is open, the software is mobilized, so to speak, and can communicate with the receiver. This means that after selecting the correct tab up here, because at the moment we are working with the S-Wave technology, we are now capable of visualizing the incoming signals which arrive at the receiver. That was the flashing of the LED in the form of a telegram structure. We can see that here. I repeat the actuation of the switch, the signals are sent to the receiver and are visualized by the software. This enables users to access the telegrams and query or extract certain information from them, such as the RSSI value for field strength or the battery status. In order to connect to a control system, for example an PLC implementation, steute provides a telegram description, which you can also find as a download on our website.
Die benötigten Informationen aus dem Telegramm herauszufiltern.